Welcome back to Shop Talk. I'm Ria Tanjuatco Trillo. We're now joined by BENG RAGON, the artist behind Beadwords for Josephyne, and visual artist Christine Shoco. BENG and Christine are just some of the artists whose works will be featured at the Summer Fair Art Fest happening on April 2nd at the Bahay ng Alumni in UP Diliman. Hello, ladies. Thanks for coming on Shop Talk.
Hello, good afternoon.
Okay, let's start with BENG. Yes. BENG, you have an interesting story as to how your beadwork business began back in 2007.
Yes, my line is called Beadwords for Josephyne. I created this in memory of my mom, Josephyne, when she passed away in 2007. Actually, my love for beading was inspired by a poem I wrote for her in 2007. So the concept became a fusion of the art of beading and the art of poetry. And to also celebrate the fashion era she grew up with, which was the 60s and 70s, my works are reflective of the Bohemian fashion.
Okay, and you sell, tell us a bit more about the accessories that that we have here in front of us.
As an artist, I also wanted to advocate and promote love for the environment. So recently, I came up with this collection called Beads, Bohemian Eco Art and Designs, using recyclable materials like plastic cups, leather straps, and flat cords. So as you can see, I have this Bohemian Eco bags. The embellishments are made of plastic cups and old leather straps. And I also have recycled boho bracelets and also the hippie abacus necklaces.
Okay, yeah, very 1960s and 70s. And are those the ring pulls from cans?
From pull tabs.
Oh, okay.
The main elements are the soda can tabs. So I embellished them with flat cords and used ribbons and also loose beads.
All right. Yes. Okay, Christine, let's talk about your stuff now. You're really a visual artist by profession, and now you've made all kinds of accessories and bags. How did you start doing that?
I created bags. It all started when I met my partner in 2008. I started doing my beads when I became inspired by his works. He also do his beads using semi-precious stone and local indigenous products that we can find here in the Philippines. So I decided to create my own style. So I started using macrame, using wax cord, and I combined also found objects with some of the local indigenous products here in the Philippines.
And I see there's some terracotta beads. So ikaw mismo gumagawa ng beads, right? So you form them and fire them, is that right?
Yeah, I personally made it by myself. Then with the help of some of my friends in Labrador, Pangasinan, We're dun kasi galing yung putik. We sculpt the beads, then we fire it. Then after that, I put paintings on it to enhance the beauty of the beads.
Yes, I can see there's some star or flower designs on some of them, right?
For both of you, what's the design process? Do you have an idea of how you want something to look and then you create it? Or iniipon nyo yung mga materiales and then you decide what you can make out of it after that?
Well, for me, it's basically very free-flowing. And since I'm a writer, the process is pretty much the same when I'm writing. Like, to start with, I should have parang a clear concept in mind, what I want to do. Mm-hmm. Then with the right materials, the right inspiration, then the creativity will flow in.
For you, Christine, how does it go?
As a visual artist, I look into the material itself, its character, how it would fit with other materials I combine with. So, also, I'm also, one of my discipline is the found object art. So, aside from that, painting is also one of my discipline also. And every time I finish my product, like my handmade bags, mm-hmm. I put paintings.
Oh, okay, so the bags with the paintings on it, those are yours.
Yeah.
Okay, how much time do you guys spend actually making your stuff? How many hours a day on average?
Well, it depends.
It depends.
It's great takes parang a day to a week. Okay. So it depends on the process you put into each work, into each design. So it also depends on the inspiration and the flow of creativity when creating these items.
Yeah, would you say it's the same for you?
Yeah, same with BENG. depends the energy I have to finish my work, and also the inspiration and the concept in my mind that I have to put it into my work.
Right. Pero may mga days ba na parang hindi nyo feel mag-create ng, you know, mga accessories or mga bags nyo? Sort of like, maybe you can liken it to writer's block. Is there such thing as like an artist's block?
For me, yes. Yeah, there are times na wala talagang inspiration. And even kasi yung small things, di ba? Parang yung mga little wonders na you see in life, that can be an inspiration. So those small things can really spark your creativity.
Okay. Christine, what do you do pag wala kang inspiration?
Sometimes artists have that tinatawag na mood swings.
Right. Artistic mood swings. Okay.
Yeah. So whenever I don't feel like doing my work, so di ko muna siya gagawin. So when I'm not my mood, then inspired akong gumawa. And I'm willing to finish it same time.
Right. And I think you also want to be in a place where you really want to create anyway. Yes. Diba? You can't really force yourself to do it because goodness only knows what you'll end up with at the end of the day, right?
Yeah.
Okay. It's very exciting that you guys are joining Step Up, which is happening on April 2nd. But, you know, that kind of event doesn't happen every day. Yeah. Where are your goods available, you know, when there is no actual event?
We have a strong presence online via Multiply and Facebook.
Okay.
So they can check out our products on Facebook and Multiply.
All right. Same for you also,
Christine. Same with Facebook. And I also post some of my products and services at sulit.com.ph. Also called as Buy and Sell Philippines.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
So really everywhere. Okay. Now looking at your stuff, you know, it's so varied and so different. What's the price range?
My bags, my handmade bags, price range from 500 to 1,000. It just depends on the size, mm-hmm. how spacious they are,
right?
How
right.
utilitarian the design also. And my accessories, price range from 100 to 500 pesos.
Okay.
It's so still negotiable, you know.
Negotiable, right?
Yeah.
So, kung may magana magpakyaw ng mga stuff nyo, you can always get a discount. What about
for me,
Josephyne?
I want my products to be very affordable, to really cater to those boho chic fashionistas. Mm-hmm. Yung those who have this appreciation for ukay-ukay, for thrift shops. So, between 50 and 500, they can choose from a wide array of really unique and sentimental pieces.
Right. So who normally buys your stuff? Well, you mentioned, of course, the boho
yes.
chick. But is it mostly students, yeah. working women? Who would you say your clientele is?
Well, for me, most of my products are a hit among students. The hippies, the gypsies, the boho chick fashionistas.
Okay. And for you, Christine?
Both sides. All people in ages. Students, artists, the young professionals also.
All right. Well, we definitely look forward to seeing all of your stuff on April 2nd at Step Up happening in Bahay ng Alumni in UP Diliman. Ben, Christine, thank you for coming on Shop Talk.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All right. I thank all of you for watching the show. I'm Ria Tanjuatco Trillo. Please follow ANC Shop Talk on Twitter and be a fan of ANC Shop Talk on Facebook. Join us again tomorrow. Enjoy the rest of your day.